The Moon, our nearest and distant neighbor. Though its face appears unchanged, the Moon has a violent and dynamic history that spans billions of years. Thanks to NASA's Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, we now understand both how the Moon formed and how we explore it today. From year to year, the Moon seems still, its craters and plains frozen in time. But it wasn't always like this. Roughly 4.5 billion years ago, a giant collision between Earth and a Mars-sized object formed a ring of debris. That debris clustered into a molten sphere, the newborn Moon. As it cooled, a crust formed above the sea of magma. Then, around 4.3 billion years ago, a massive impact near the South Pole created the South Pole 18 Basin, sending debris all the way to the far side of the Moon. This was just the beginning. Over millions of years, more enormous collisions covered the lunar surface, carving out deep basins. These later became the maria, dark patches we see today, as lava seeped through cracks in the thin crust filling the basins. The volcanic rock that fills them was rich in iron and darker than the surrounding highlands, giving the Moon its iconic face. About 1 billion years ago, volcanic activity on the near side ceased. Smaller meteorites continued to bombard the surface, creating recognizable features like Tycho, Copernicus, and Aristarchus craters, their bright rays stretching across the Moon's face. Today, the Moon remains a celestial fossil, preserving its own story and offering a glimpse into the early history of the Earth. Now, let's take a journey across the modern lunar landscape, seen through the eyes of the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter. The Moon. It's our nearest neighbor in space, and data we gather from its features can tell us a lot about the rest of our solar system. And through the eyes of the LR spacecraft, we can explore the lunar surface in all new ways in fascinating detail. Our tour begins on the western border, where the near side of the Moon meets the far side. The enormous feature is the lunar crater, and is known as the Oriental Basin. Here, LRO's Terran map combines with the surface gravity measurement from the Grail mission. This data reveals structure in the lunar crust beneath the surface, giving us a window into the geologic features of the Moon's interior. Our next location receives little direct sunlight and has some of the coldest recorded temperatures in the solar system, the South Pole. The highlighted spots signify potential water ice based on temperature readings from LRO's Divina instrument and reflectance from its laser altimeter LOLA. LOLA also allows us to peer into the darkness of Shackleton crater by bringing us this digital elevation model. It's 21 kilometers wide and 4 kilometers deep, but it pales in comparison to the largest non-impact crater in the Earth-Moon system, the South Pole 18 Basin. Sitting on the far side, it's 2500 kilometers across and 13 kilometers deep. We don't yet know exactly how old the basin is, but it was first seen in the 1960s by spacecraft flying around the far side. As much as we use LRO's data to investigate areas we can't see from Earth, we also probe familiar territory on the lunar near side to bring back images with all new level of detail. This is Tycho crater. It's around 100 billion years old. Here, the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter camera captures the central peak with a 100-meter-wide boulder at the summit, the origins of which are still a mystery. Continuing across Moon's near side, we will arrive in an area ripe for future explorations due to the diversity of impact and volcanic materials. It features a prominent crater so bright it's not only visible through telescopes but also to the naked eye. Welcome to the Aristarchus Plateau. Here, infrared shows the mineral pyroxene in orange and a splash of plagioclase in blue from Aristarchus Crater. This region can tell us a lot about the rich volcanic history of the moon. As much as we study the moon, looking for sites to visit, we also look back at places we've already been. This is because the new data that LRO is gathering helps us interpret the geology of familiar places, giving scientists a better understanding of the sequence of events in early lunar history. Here, we descend to the Apollo 17 landing site in the Taurus Littoral Valley, which is deeper than the Grand Canyon. The path the astronauts took over the course of 3 days is shown. The Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter camera is even able to capture a view of the bottom half of the Apollo 17 lunar lander, which still sits on the surface, as well as the rover vehicle. These images help preserve our accomplishment of human exploration at the moon's surface. Moving onward, we make our way to our final destination. The location contains regions that exist in permanent shadow, as well as ones that bask in nearly perpetual light. The North Pole. Detailed terrain measurements by LOLA allow scientists to model sunlight and shadow at the poles over decades and centuries. Sunlit peaks and crater rims here may be ideal locations for generating solar power for future expeditions to the moon. This updated visualization of the lunar landscape stands as a testament to the functionality and abilities of the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter spacecraft. And as the mission continues to gather data, it will provide us with many more opportunities to take a tour of our moon. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe for more amazing content. We've got plenty of exciting videos coming your way, so hit the bell icon and stay tuned.